What's good, everybody? Welcome back to the Philly Sports Network YouTube channel. And today, we're going to be talking about a little bit of baseball. You know, we're going to switch it up a little bit. Football season is officially over. The Chiefs are the Super Bowl champions. Shout out to Andy Reid. Shout out to LeSean McCoy. But as you can see by the jersey, it's baseball season. I'm Jalen Smoot. I've been riding with Philly Sports Network for about going on four years now, covering the Phillies. And today I just wanted to do a quick off-season review of the Phillies and kind of talk about where we're at and give a season outlook on how I think the 2020 season will go for the Phillies. Spoiler alert, it's not great. It'll be fun. It'll be a fun season. I think we have a nice competitive ball club, but it's not gonna be easy. It's not gonna be particularly easy to accumulate wins this season, especially in a very competitive, talented NL East. But with that being said, let's go ahead and jump right into it. So the Phillies began the offseason very, very slow. The first move of the offseason was actually claiming a reliever from the Boston Red Sox, Trevor Kelly, off waivers. Who's since been waived. And then after that, you know, we signed Andrew Knapp to a one-year deal, pretty much let Michael Franco and Cesar Hernandez walk out of the door. So it began very, very, very slowly, especially in comparison to last offseason. The Phillies pretty much emptied out the vault. Last season, I believe we spent $403 million. Obviously, we brought in JT Realmuto, we brought in Bryce Harper, we brought in Gene Segura, Andrew McCutchen. You know, last year we were going for it all. This year, obviously, with the luxury tax limitations that the front office placed on themselves, they didn't want to exceed the luxury tax, which I kind of understand. Obviously, I would like to see a team, a big market team such as the Phillies, be a little bit more inclined to spend, especially with the NL East being so tightly packed and so competitive. Quite literally, the reigning World Series champion in division. So we need to make moves. But at the same time, as Matt Klintak alluded to a little earlier this offseason, we won 80 plus games last season. A lot of things did go wrong. Rhys Hoskins completely forgot how to hit a baseball. Andrew McCutchen tore his ACL. Jake Arrieta had the elbow issue. Aaron Nola regressed. So there was a lot going on last season. So I can understand that maybe with a better fortune with injuries, how we could kind of improve. But this offseason, looking at the moves, it doesn't inspire that much confidence that the Phillies are gonna end their playoff drought this season. But let's go ahead and look into some of the moves that we did actually accomplish. So strangely enough, like I said, after spending $403 million last offseason, the Phillies only handed out two major league contracts the entire offseason. Obviously, we still have a little bit of time before spring training kicks off, so they may add one more guy, but it's not looking particularly likely. Now, the two major league packs that we did hand out, I feel like will pay huge dividends. The first was Zach Wheeler, formerly of the Mets, starting pitcher. We gave him a five-year, $118 million contract. A little lofty, but nothing out of the ordinary. You know, the luxury tax goes up every year. Players are gonna get more and more money every year. So $118 million for Zach Wheeler isn't too bad. And I wrote a piece a little earlier this offseason, just kind of talking about the steps that he could take to evolving into a staff ace, because Wheeler does have a ton of potential. Fastball had the fourth highest average velocity among starters last season, a little over 96 miles per hour. Big looping curveball, his slider has a lot of bite to it. According to Fangraphs, it was the second highest average velocity slider as well. Nice little changeup, and he even mixes in a two-seamer from time to time. The Phillies are hoping with new Phillies pitching coach Brian Price that he could bring out the best in Wheeler, because he hasn't been terribly efficient over the course of his career. He's pitched in the big leagues, I believe, five seasons now. Career ERA over 3.4. Never has had more than 12 wins in a season. Never has pitched 200 innings in a single season. I don't believe he's ever recorded 200 strikeouts in a season either, which doesn't sound very inspiring as far as, you know, becoming a staff ace. But like I said, it's really all in his stuff. It's really gonna come down to coaching and game planning for him with the Phillies. So that's a move I feel like we could be excited about, because at the very least, he's better than Vince Velasquez, Zach Eflin, Cole Irvins of the world, the Jared Eichhoffs of the world. You know, just kind of giving Aaron Nola that much, much needed beta dog in the Phillies rotation, somebody that we can roll out there every fifth day that actually is at the very least an MLB capable starter, not just minor league guys or guys who really should belong in the bullpen and things like that. So that's a move that I'm fairly excited about. Not too long after that, we gave infielder Didi Gregorius 1 year, $14 million pack. As you know, Gregorius played with new Philly skipper Joe Girardi with the Yankees. Very, very talented player. Plus bat, plus defender, good clubhouse guy, good, you know, he does a lot of charitable acts. He's just a good locker room presence to have. I believe they say he speaks six languages. Communication is not going to be an issue for him. Hopefully he's very well received with the team and can kind of give the players, obviously he's not just like a Joe Girardi's teacher's pet or anything like that, but he will give the players some kind of insight on what to expect from Girardi, and that helps a lot. But obviously his on-the-field impact is going to supersede all that. I think plugging him in at shortstop will help us a lot. So we'll have Kingery at third, Gregorius at short. We'll slide Segura over to second base, and then we'll have Hoskins. So he'll help lengthen the lineup a little bit. I felt like, especially with Hoskins' struggles last season, I really felt like the Phillies were one batter short of really making an impact in the National League. We were a little too over-reliant on the production of Harper, Realmuto, and Hoskins, which of course, you know, if those are the engines of your offense, like, you know, you're gonna expect big things from them. But having Gregorius, who's got some pop, he's able to bat for contact, bat for average, he's got some pop, and he's a left-handed hitter. So having a lefty bat in the lineup should help us a lot as well. But unfortunately, like I said, that was the last major league deal that the Phillies handed out this offseason. After that, it's just been a slew of minor league contracts. Phil Gosselin, Josh Harrison, Francisco Liriano, Neil Walker, Bud Harris, Juice Thorne. We just claimed Reggie McClain this past Friday off waivers. Appear to be implementing a new strategy of improving the roster. After emptying the vault last season, they seem a little bit more cautious with their spending, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. It's just, I don't know, it's a little atypical because the Phillies are usually very affluent and very, you know, cost heavy. Like I said, it's not a bad thing. You know, maybe a change of strategy is what we need. I would have liked to see us go out and get at least one major league reliever or two. The sad news is, after coming into the offseason, you know, third, you know, ranked as like the third, fourth best team in the division, I don't think we can confidently say that we've taken the steps to become the second or even the first best team in the division. The Braves obviously signed Will Smith, not the actor, obviously, Will Smith, reliever, Cole Hamels, King Felix even made his trip to Atlanta, and they got Marcell Ozuna not too long ago. So the Braves, after coming into the offseason, clearly a peg or two ahead of the Phillies, I feel like they're still right there. The Nationals, obviously, they lost star third baseman Anthony Rendon to the Angels fairly early in the offseason, but they still retain Steven Strasburg, and with the pitching staff they have, with Strasburg, Scherzer, Corbin, I mean, they're still going to be competitive, and I would contest that they're still better than the Phillies at present. I just don't think that the Phillies have done enough. As I said, Wheeler will help our rotation, but I'm still not very confident that our rotation will be competitive enough to end our playoff drought, if that makes sense. The Mets, yikes! They have hired two managers this offseason. Yeah, it's not going very well in Flushing, New York. So, and the Marlins are the Marlins. So, you know, we're not really terribly worried about them, even though they had our number last season, but obviously we're not too worried about the Marlins as far as the division outlook goes. As far as the season outlook for the Phillies, man, I think that we are going to need MVP Harper to compete. In his second season with the Phillies, after coming, you know, from the Nationals, you know, last season he was adjusting to a new city, new life. He was playing for a new team for the first time in years. So obviously it wasn't going to be the most productive season for him at the plate. I'm expecting big things from him this offseason. Yeah, a lot of pressure is going to be on his shoulders. I'm not going to lie. I think the Phillies, realistically speaking, I think that we're aiming for a wild card slot. obviously we would like to win the division pennant, but I personally don't think that's in the cards. Like, I just don't think that's in the cards. We just do not have the pitching available. Unless Spencer Howard is gonna come into the show and just set the league on fire as a rookie, which it's within the realm of possibility. If I were a gambling man, I wouldn't bet my house on it. But yeah, I think the Phillies can win somewhere between 88, 95 ball games this year. You know, we won 80 last year and a lot of things did go wrong. We're getting McCutchen back. Year two of JT Realmuto. A similar situation with McCutchen, Harper, and Realmuto, like, and Segura, actually. Last year was the first season in Philly for all of them. So in year two, they'll be a little bit more comfortable at CBP. One thing that cannot be understated is how vast of an improvement we are along the staff, especially at our manager position. Having Joe Girardi, former World Series champion, former manager of the year, having his veteran leadership, his expertise, as opposed to what we had in Kapler, which I'm not even gonna dive into Kapler. He's in San Francisco now, and I am very happy about that. That's all that needs to be said on that. Having Joe Girardi, he should be able to manufacture, you know, a few more wins for the Phillies this season, as well as we have lengthened that lineup. And even though I'm not incredibly confident in the rotation, we did add Zach Wheeler. So every pitcher other than Nola gets knocked down in the pegging order in the rotation. So that should help. Because last season, having Jake Arrieta as your number two is, oh my gosh, that was frustrating. You know, that's not a recipe for success. Having Wheeler as our number two should help a ton. Like I said, the Nationals are a little bit worse. Maybe we'll be able to compete with them a little bit more. The Braves are going to be tough, man. I'm not going to lie. The Braves are going to be tough. Like I said, the National League East is just kind of loaded right now. I know the Phillies have made some big moves over the last few years, but this is just a different division now. It's not as easy to rise your way to the top as it was in seasons prior, which is why I believe we'll mainly be gunning for the wild card slot this season. But with that being said, I do think we have more than enough talent to bring home one of those wild card spots. I definitely, without a shadow of a doubt, believe that. I'm not gonna sit here and say that the Phillies have no shot at ending their playoff drought. I'm just saying that we have an uphill climb. With that being said, like, that's just kind of the season outlook, how I kind of feel about us right now with spring training on the horizon. Be on the lookout for more videos moving forward, especially, you know, covering the Phillies and whatnot. I'll probably do a few Eagles videos here and there, maybe Sixers, but largely Phillies covers this season. So I'm just looking forward to meeting all you guys in the YouTube community, and I'll see you later.